Las Vegas, pre-sale happening right now, March 25th at the Wynn. I'm coming. I'm bringing TT Jerry. An hour of stand-up at the Wynn Hotel, March 25th. Pre-sale happening right now. Use the code CHAOS at ChrisDComedy.com. Go get the tickets. We're going to have a great time over there at the Wynn. Love Las Vegas. The Beacon Theater, we have released some tickets. February 5th, New York City. Go to ChrisDComedy.com for all the tickets. We got a whole theater tour coming out. Thank you guys so much for the support. Go get the tickets. And at the end of December, with Sally Babe, my baby, we're co-headlining. We got Texas. We got Ohio. We got Missouri. Go get the tickets. ChrisDComedy.com. Thanks, baby.
All right, I finally got some dates for you guys. I will be at the Dania Improv in Fort Lauderdale on November 12th, 13th, and 14th. I will be at the West Palm Beach Improv December 4th and 5th. I will be in Boston in the Medford area at the Chevalier Theater on December 10th. And how about this? First time playing Atlantic City solo. I'm at the Borgata Saturday, December 11th. Come on down for that. All tickets at salvulcanocomedy.com right now. And more dates to be announced soon. I have not been out. I'm finally coming out after COVID. You better be there.
Don't be a fake. Don't be a flake. Don't run away from your feelings, babe. Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. Don't hesitate to say, hey, babe. Hey, babe. Hey, babe. Hey, babe. Hey, babe.
Hey, babe, from the outside. I must have called a thousand times to tell you I'm sorry for everything that I've done. But when I call you, you never seem to be home. Hey, babe, from the other side.
What's up, babe?
Hey, baby, how you doing?
Good, baby, how are you?
I'm good.
You look good, you feel good. You
Thanks.
Look out, you've been you've been dieting a little bit,
yeah.
Which has been nice to see. You've been eating a lot of Aussie bites, which are keto. Shout out the Aussies. How do you feel?
I feel good. I'm wearing button-down shirts now. I'm just trying to change my look a little.
Well, it's interesting because one of the other episodes, I put on a button-down shirt, and you were like, I've never seen you in a button-down. I said, I've never seen you in a button-down. Now I have. Good for you, man. Dude, how about this? Woman is 7 feet, 0.7 inches tall. Tallest woman in the world. 7 feet, 0.7, which, you know, you would think it's not even
what?
Really that tall. Could you date a 7 foot woman?
No, that is tall.
Very tall.
Yeah, I would date a 7 foot woman.
You would?
Yeah, because honestly, everyone, you know, is really tall. I'm only 5'10".
Her name's Rumiesa Gelgi. Should we Rumiesa Gelgi, the world's tallest living woman.
Wow. Okay.
Oh, she speaks great English. Okay. And she's from Saffron Balu, Turkey. Oh, only 24 years old. She's got already been in a wheelchair,
wow.
Unfortunately.
But
I'd love to get her. Do you think the girl with the world's biggest mouth can fit her in her mouth?
Ah.
Yeah. Well, you're all right. What's wrong with your throat?
No, I'm just saying. I was trying to open my mouth too.
Do you know that, you know, because we're in New York, do you know that
Me?
They do the show?
Do I know?
Do you know?
Me.
Do you know that they do the show Sesame Street in Long Island City, New York? Did you know that? Our whole life, Sesame Streets.
Our whole life from day one.
Uh-oh. How about this? Ready for this?
Swear.
Big news out of China. China's test of the hypersonic vehicle is part of a program to rapidly expand strategic and nuclear systems. So now, Sally Babes, China has developed a nuclear weapon that can go into outer space and land on a target anywhere in the continental United States or any country in about 15 mins.
Oh, my God.
What do you think of that?
I don't like where everything's headed.
I don't. Yeah. How about this?
It worries me. It actually worries me, you know?
It does. Yeah. You know, most recently in August, my birthday was August 26th.
What's up, Pimby?
Hey, how's it going, man? You look great.
How you
today?
Doing, buddy?
Most recently in August, China tested a nuclear-capable hypersonic vehicle that partially orbited the globe before hurling toward Earth. It also has constructed hundreds of new missile silos. You all right?
Oh, my God.
Oh, and it's building a new generation of strategic ballistic missile submarines. So
I can't take this. My heart's pounding a mile a minute.
Well, really? Well,
yeah.
Me and Pip have talked to you about this. I mean, we think it's time for you to stop doing blow.
I got the nose for it.
You do have the nose for it. That's the problem with
little
you.
Little booger sugar up here.
I know, dude. I know. Yeah. It's interesting. It's interesting because I was like, what is different about Sal today? And your nose does look like a cheese doodle.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Have you been hitting the Peloton a lot?
Oh, man. We got a Peloton. Shout out Peloton. And if you're listening, and we know that you are, I really like your product.
Wow. Yeah. I love it. Dude, I mean, I'm freaking excited. I'm freaking excited to go hit the road with you, too. I mean, it's
going
to be great.
Oh, we are going to kill. We're going away for the Christmas holiday weekend.
Could you imagine that? December 26th to the 31st, me, Sally Babes right here, and the homeless pimp will be on the road.
Us three.
Co-headlining stand-up shows in Texas. We got Sugarland, Houston, Dallas.
Then St. Louis.
St. Louis. Columbus, Ohio, and Cincinnati on New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve!
December 26th, 31st. Go to ChristyComedy.com, SalVulcanoComedy.com, and we got a bunch of solo dates up there, too. Why the hell not, babe? We're doing it. We did it. Now, what do you think about Dave Chappelle?
What was the slogan that you said last episode?
The babes.
Nobody does it like the
nobody
babes.
Does it like
nobody
the babes.
Does it like the babes.
Nobody does it like the babes. How about this? They found the body of Brian Laundry. What do you think of that?
No, they didn't.
Yes, they did.
No, they didn't.
Yes, they did.
Swear to God.
Swear to God.
The body?
His body.
No.
They found his body.
I can't tell if you're joking.
No. Is this?
He's dead?
He's dead. They found his body.
He killed himself?
Well, they said the remains of him next to his belongings. So, yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What's the story?
Yeah, it's what happens, yeah. So oh five God. Bodies have been found in the same general area since Brian Laundry went missing. So there is a potential serial killer in the Utah area. I will be in Salt Lake City November 4th to the 6th. If you'd like to come to the show.
Do you guys think you ever cross paths with a serial killer in Manhattan?
A serial killer? I would say the likelihood
has to be strong.
I mean, there's 9 million people circulating New York City pre-pandy-wandy at what any given day. We were in the city all day, every day. Absolutely, two things. We absolutely probably have to cross paths with someone who went on to become a serial killer, and we also definitely cross paths with someone's last day on Earth.
Oh, God, yeah. Like that happens probably more than we think, even.
Oh, yeah.
There are as many as 50 serial killers operating today. Someone who kills three or more people is generally called a serial killer. So it doesn't really take much to be a serial killer.
That's so funny. Like, if you killed only two people, you're not a serial killer.
You're not a serial killer. It's got to be three or more.
Oh, wow.
What can you do? I don't know.
Sal, I actually wanted to ask you, what's your biggest fear?
Be honest with us. It's just me and you talking.
Probably death.
You think death is your biggest fear?
Yeah.
What scares you about death? Because so many people have said when they take like DMT or have near-death experiences that they don't fear death anymore.
Well, maybe that's something I need to do then. Because
do you want to do DMT on Hey Babe? Nights. Do you want to do DMT on Hey Babe?
Is it legal?
Question. Pimp, is it legal? Joe Rogan does it.
It depends on the state.
Probably not legal in the state of New York.
Is it dangerous?
I mean, everything's a little dangerous.
No, but this seems like you're messing with, like, a chemical that you're not supposed to.
Well, no, we all have DMT inside our brains.
Right.
Unfortunately, how about this? Jamie Lee Curtis says plastic surgery is wiping out a generation of beauty. I'll tell you what, Sal.
I would agree.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You look like the kind of person that will never need plastic surgery and never want plastic surgery. Is that correct?
Absolutely correct. I would never do it.
You would never, ever do it. There's not one part of your body that you wish you could fix.
Oh, there's like 100 parts.
Yeah.
No joke. No joke at all. But I just wouldn't put myself through that.
What part of your body do you think you hate the most? Mine are my nipples.
Yeah.
Mine are my nipples, my feet.
Yeah, my feet I don't like.
My side fat.
Yeah, I don't like that. That for me too.
And my side profile.
I hate it. I hate my chipped tooth.
My back.
My pussy, my crack.
How about this? 11% of women surveyed indicated that they are more interested in cosmetic plastic surgery or non-surgical procedures now than before COVID-19. And the figure is even higher among women who have already had surgery or procedure, 24% respectively.
Look, I can't speak for people that don't like what they look at in the mirror every day and feel that they need to do that. But I don't like what's going on now in the world where people are doing it to become right. This unnatural shape and figure and all that stuff. It's affecting the youth.
It is affecting the youth.
Well, you guys should hear what Jamie Lee, why she got her plastic surgery done. It's actually pretty crazy.
Let's hear it. Big Jamie Lee Curtis fan. I used to masturbate to her in True Lies.
Same.
Telling Variety that she had what was called routine surgery after a cameraman said her eyes were too puffy.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
I was mortified and so embarrassed and had so much shame.
What?
Did he really say that?
She's Jamie Lee Curtis.
And you said her eyes
are too puffy.
Cameraman said your eyes are too puffy.
A camera guy makes a passing comment and she goes under the knife?
Yeah, no. And first of all, there's no way he said that.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. He's like, hey, puffy lady.
Yeah. What's up, cheese puff eyes? What else? So that's the reason why.
Well, she was just saying, I guess, after the, you know, a lot of the reality stars are all done up. So now young girls are getting plastic surgery, not older women who it's meant for.
Yeah, girls are getting plastic surgery in their teens now. It's crazy.
And one thing thing she said is once you change your face, you can't get it back, which is
true.
Yeah.
Like, you can always get very your true. Boobs.
I've thought about getting a nose job.
No.
Yeah, because.
Why? No, you don't need. Your nose is perfect the way it is.
Yeah.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
You are beautiful.
How?
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful. It's true.
Don't Wait, you know that guy?
Sings James that song? Blunt?
Oh, you know James Blake.
James Blake Blunt. Is a friend. Yes, I love James Blake.
But not James Blake.
Shout out James Blake.
Shout out James Blake.
Raise the roof.
The roof. The roof. Roof. The roof is on fire. We don't need no
water. Let the motherfucker burn. Burn, motherfucker.
Absolutely.
Let me ask you a question. How big do the asses need to be? The asses are huge now.
Well, you
huge.
Know, well, Sal, you know that I love Latinas, and I love that ass. So for me, the ass actually can't be big enough, and it's something I talk to my therapist about at BetterHelp.com. About the asses, for me, there's not a size where I say that's too much.
Wow. I don't disagree if it's natural, but the injections, Chris, the injections.
It because then when does it end? When does it end? I mean, how much, you know, because then next thing you know, your ass is a raft.
All of a sudden, your ass is out to here. You know what I mean?
Next thing you know, I'm taking your ass from Cuba to get to the Florida.
You're getting freedom off that ass.
Look at that ass. There you go. And then so what happens is when you get it.
Wow.
That's a big butt.
That's wild. Is that gone wrong?
This is Butt Shots Gone Bad, which is a new TV show.
Wow, I love this.
The fake butt phenomenon. Yeah, it's a little bit. One girl's ass broke and leaked and she died.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you can die from it. You can die from a fake ass.
Damn, I didn't even know that.
Imagine you get killed by a fake ass.
Well, I could think of worse ways to go.
What's a worse way to go than being killed by a fake ass? Go ahead, give me one example.
Shot in the head.
You'd rather be shot in the head?
No. I said I could think of worse ways to go than being killed by an ass.
Being smothered by a fake ass seems like a pretty nice way to go out.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Got it. Okay. I think the worst way to die, though, is being eaten alive by an animal. I've said this. Being eaten alive by a bear or an underwater animal. Yeah. I don't want to get eaten alive by a shark.
Oh, what about?
Then I got to die in the middle of the ocean.
Yeah, what about buried alive? Ooh.
Buried alive. Might be the scariest way to die.
Scary.
Scary, scary, scary. Because you just, or being left alone in a room with no way to get out.
Yep.
That's or maybe, even worse, or maybe that's just take 30 days.
Locked in a studio with Island Boys looping. No food and water.
No food and water.
That'd be great. Imagine ISIS is using Island Boys as torture.
Dude, look at homeless.
Island boy, I'm an island boy.
Dude,
I'm an island boy. I'm an island boy.
I love it, dude. Did you see homeless pimp shirt? Speaking of Island Boys, he's got two different shirts on, but it's one shirt meshed
Nobody's
together.
Fit is better than homeless pimp's fit.
Homeless pimp's fit is fire, and his glasses now are fire.
But also, I agree. I totally agree, but check this out. A hot pepper shirt? Come on.
That's great.
Good point.
Come on, babe.
I have a Zanies Nashville sweatshirt, and that's pretty dope. Yeah. Shout out Zanies Nashville. Shout out Lucy. Zanies. Shout out everyone at Zanies. What a great comedy club.
Love it. Love that club.
Love that club.
Maybe they put me on the wall soon. Who knows?
Are they going to put you on the wall? Maybe a truck will drive through it, like what happened to Nate Bargatze.
Right into Nate's face.
Oh, I love Nate. Shout out, Nate.
Shout out, Bargatze.
Our lunch just got here. I'll go get it for you guys.
You got lunch for us?
Thank you, man. I was so hungry. I needed the break for a second.
Yeah.
And shout out Pastavino.
Oh, phenomenal. Jesus.
Lunch from Pastavino, my favorite restaurant on Staten Island, I think.
It was that food was fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I had the other day for the first time ever in my life? And it is fall season, and you wouldn't think I had this.
Something with a pumpkin?
Butternut squash ravioli.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
When's the last time I made a butternut squash ravioli?
You're not going to believe me.
A BINSR.
You're not going to believe me. Three nights ago from Pastavino.
We should have got
the brown butter sage, like squash ravioli was delicious.
We got to do a Pastavino night.
Oh, that'd be great.
We got to do it.
I actually probably go get food from there too much to a point where it's like I shouldn't do it.
You shouldn't do it at all. Yeah. Anyway.
Like
nice,
I do
big healthy.
I'm up to like twice a week from there.
Right, but it's good.
It was so good.
It was good, and you know what I love that you always have is you're a LaCroix boy.
Oh, I'm a LaCroix boy,
and I love LaCroix.
Yeah. They got a host of flavors. LaCroix, if you're listening, and we know that you are, we want to be official LaCroix boys.
Come on, dude.
How do we do it? Oh, my God. You talk about a merger. You talk about, like, branding. We could be your LaCroix boys.
We could absolutely be your little LaCroix boys that nobody has to know about.
What about it?
Oh, no, everybody has to know about.
What about a Hey Babe flavor?
Hey Babe flavor LaCroix.
A Hey Babe flavored seltzer. What flavor would it be?
What flavor are we? I would think, are we like
if
a
we
cherry?
Were a flavor, I love cherry, but they probably have black cherry already or cherry.
You think we're black cherry? I didn't say that sounded.
I think a black cherry is my favorite cherry, no?
Your toe just hit my knee.
Sorry, baby.
Wow, that was
see these socks?
That was a moment.
I made them myself.
You made those socks?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
My friend
Chrissy bought a whole kit and we made shirts and socks, a group of us.
That's interesting. You never think to tie-dye a sock. Everyone goes right to tie-dye a shirt, but you can tie-dye other items.
You can.
That's not...
Proof positive.
That's not illegal at all.
No.
At least it's legal in New York.
You like the color... What?
It's legal in New York to
tie-dye
a sock. You can
tie-dye anything. Do you ever tie-dye anything? It's actually really fun. You put it in like a... You put it into a ball and you put rubber bands around it. So it's like completely squished together.
Yeah.
And then you have these dyes and these like ketchup bottle type things. And you just pick and you just hit it wherever you want. And you don't really know what you're doing, but you do have to pick colors that kind of would match, which I believe it did. And then when you open it, you don't know what it's going to look like until you open it.
If I was comedian Jeff Dye, I would have merch Jeff Tie-Dye.
Oh my God.
Where my face is tie-dye.
He doesn't do that?
Jeff, if you're listening, and we probably know that you actually are. Yeah. Jeff Tie-Dye, that should be your merch.
Jeff
Dye. Just to suggest, his name's Jeff Dye. Why not Jeff Tie-Dye?
Or Jeff Dye shirts. Or you got to add the tie.
I think tie.
Tie-Dye.
What do you guys think about Kiwis?
Hate them.
Love.
What else? No,
I love the country of New Zealand and its people. Are we talking about the fruit of the nation of New Zealand?
No. I'm actually working with a bunch of New Zealanders right now.
What?
On a project.
But in New Zealand? They're in New Zealand?
No, they're here in New York City.
Okay. Yeah. I was going to say, that's...
No joke, two New Zealand fellas.
Do you want to go to New Zealand like it's burning inside you, like you want to be in New Zealand?
You know, I went to Australia and I didn't factor in New Zealand. And I said, if I ever get back there, I'm making the hop. I heard New Zealand is the most beautiful, one of the most beautiful places on earth.
So what I would like to do is not even go to us, just go direct to New Zealand.
Direct.
I want to go right to Wellington, New Zealand.
What's their biggest city?
I think it's Wellington, New Zealand.
But then you got to go countryside, right?
More sheep than people in the country of New Zealand allege.
Really?
But we can't even get into New Zealand if we try right now. It doesn't even matter who you know.
Because of COVID.
You can't get in.
They're on strict lock, right?
Oh, the kiwi is not only a fruit, by the way, they're saying in New Zealand. If you travel to Etoreia, you must be careful when using the word kiwi since they use it with three different meanings. A dry kiwi is a person who was born in New Zealand. A kiwi bird is a bird that is also used as national symbol. And of course, there is the kiwi fruit to refer to the delicious fruit. What the hell is that animal?
The kiwi bird.
Really?
That's the kiwi bird? Wow.
Damn, it's got a sword on its face.
I know, it looks like an ice cream cone.
New Zealand, but the actual fruit, I find it to be a little too sweet or tart.
Kiwi? You don't like kiwi?
I don't know. Maybe I got to give it another whirl. It's always in the tray, and I always avoid it.
Well, it's interesting because kiwi, we can't be, but in fairness, I would think highly doubt we've ever ate in the continental United States. I don't know about Hawaii and Alaska, but the lower 48, we've never eaten a kiwi from New Zealand.
Do we process them here fake?
I think they make kiwis in New Jersey now.
Oh, really?
They have to. There's no way we're getting kiwi shipped from New Zealand.
So we just got the seeds and that's it?
I think so.
It doesn't have to do with climate, soil, bada blue, bada bing.
Now, here's a place I'd like to visit with you. This is a town in New Zealand on the east coast of New Zealand. Let's try to get this right, Sal.
Okay.
No, I don't want to be disrespectful.
That's not a word.
No.
The
town with the longest name. I don't want to be disrespectful because I know we have a lot of fans in New Zealand. Thank you so much for your support. We are coming to New Zealand. I promise you it's on the tour.
There's no way. Not even a New Zealander.
This is a town.
I'm going to ask the guys I'm working with if they could say that.
Ask me if they could say that and also email the podcast or DM us.
Pim, can you put the name of that town on the screen?
Yeah. I want more fan interaction on Hey Babe. Is it Hey Babe Pod at Gmail or Hey Babe Podcast?
Hey Hey Babe Pod.
Hey Babe, email Hey Babe Pod, heybabepod@gmail.com of you and your family trying to say this town.
Oh my
and
God.
And we're going to pick the winner whoever gets closest. I want more fan interaction. We're going to really ramp this up.
Yeah.
Email our podcast. So this is the town. It is called Tau.
You want to take a shot at it?
Let's do it slow. Do you want to? And when I get out of breath, you take over.
Okay.
So focus.
Okay. I'm focusing.
Okay. Tau Mata Waka Tangi Hanga Kawau Tamatea. You go.
Terapuka Piki Manga Hornuka Pokai Wen Yukitana Tahu.
Nailed it. Absolutely nailed it.
I mean,
the pimp is gone, by the way. Pimp has left. Walked off the show. Pimp decided to, homeless pimp, you can't see his camera. He's fully walked off the show. So we're kind of flying without a parachute
is
right
this
now.
This also probably the longest word in the world.
Is it longer than supercalifragilisticexpialidocious?
I feel like it blows it out of the water.
Do you think, well, let's count the letters while Pimp is.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 16 on the first?
16 is what
the
I
first
got.
Part.
Okay. 18? 34? 1, 2, Jesus. We're counting the letters.
36?
We're counting the letters in a word. What happened?
Sorry, guys. The Uber Eats guy just doesn't understand where I am.
Really?
Yeah, sorry about that.
You got to drop Jesus. A pin.
What'd you get, a salad?
Needed a salad.
You got to drop a pin.
Is that what it is?
It's, yeah.
You have to drop a pin.
I got 36 on the third line.
So 16 plus 18, 34 70, plus 36. 70 letters so far.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 82 letters.
82 letters. So is this word the long? What is the longest word in the world is what we want you to Google. How many letters is the longest word in the world?
It might pull up a dictionary word and not a town, though.
Okay, so the longest word in the world is.
But why does it say longest word in the world, New Zealand?
Probably because of my search history.
Okay. Pneumono ultra microscopic silicovolcano conchios.
Sal Vulcano is in the longest name of the world. Oh my God. Holy shit.
What does that mean? A word that refers to a lung disease contracted from the inhalation of very fine silica particles, specifically from a volcano. Medically, it's the same as ciliosis. Silicosis.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Yeah.
What's the longest word in the world that takes 3 hours to say? What? Titan? Has 1,089... Okay, hold on. Wait a second. You'll be surprised to know that the longest word in English has 1,089,819 letters, and it will take you 3.5 hours to pronounce it correctly. This is the chemical name of Titan, the largest known protein. What?
Never heard that. Why have we never heard that?
Why have we never heard of that? And what is the point of that? And has anyone in their life ever nailed it?
That's
and
then it. Look at it. Is that it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's insane. It's paragraphs of the same word.
Has anyone ever read the longest word in the world?
Can you type in someone saying the name of that town?
Yes.
Or that word.
Yes.
Right?
Someone saying the name.
Maybe
Google.
Copy it like someone saying.
How to pronounce.
Oh, my God.
Here we go.
Get this wrong, but that's how to say it. It's F, and most people, UH in Maori sounds like F, the sound of the letter F, and most people get this wrong, but that's how to say it. Let's try this again. Tau mata faka tangi hanga ko au au o tamate atu ripu kaka piki maunga horo nuku pokai fenua ki tanata.
Let's open up the next Hey Babe with that song. Can we listen to that again?
I swear to God, in the middle of that, he said motherfucker.
Motherfucker.
He said motherfucker in the middle of that.
It's almost in the beginning. He says, go ahead, go ahead.
It's pretty straightforward. Tau mata faka tangi hanga ko au au o tamate atu ripu kaka piki maunga horo nuku pokai fenua ki tanata.
Island boy.
Island boy. That's the name of the first album. I'm going to name that the name of my first special. I mean, even if you're from New Zealand, no way.
Do we have to do a show in this town?
Oh my God.
Do we absolutely?
On sale. Every promo. Every time you put it up on the screen. Oh my God. You can't even tweet it.
Oh, what's the meaning of the name? It means the summit. That's what. Oh, the summit where Tomatia, the man with the big knees, the slider, climber of mountains, the land swallower who traveled about, played his flute.
To his loved one.
There it is.
Wow. I would see that. That would be ridiculous to name a town all those words.
Yeah, I mean, you could have. Can we have just called it, I mean, Tomatiaville?
Yeah.
That's what we would have called it in America. That would have been translated to Tomatia Town.
Yeah. T-ville.
Oh, the name was featured in a Mountain Dew jingle.
No way.
It also appears in the 1976 single, The Lone Ranger. What? Oh, so this has been around for a while. Oh, wow, look, we got to go find this sign. I really, in my heart of hearts, want to go to New Zealand. I actually want to go to New Zealand more than I want to go to Australia. No disrespect to Australia, I want to go there too. But New Zealand seems like untapped.
Yeah, untapped, you're right, yeah.
But we can't
the
go.
The hobbits are down there. Right?
What do you think a direct flight first class cost to New Zealand from New York? Have to guess. First class round trippy.
I think you can get one for maybe 10 grand.
10 grand one way? Round trippy, we're
saying. I think round trip, maybe between 10 and 16 grand.
Oh, you got to stop. Oh, 20K, baby.
There's no directs, huh?
No directs. You got to go one stop in Auckland. You got a layover. You got to layover in Auckland.
No.
20,000, bubs.
Oh, you have to go there. Because to Australia, I just stopped in LA and that's it. I didn't take
interesting. Yeah, that seems odd that I got to stop in Australia. It's like we're almost there. Just keep it going.
16 grand.
But maybe Australia. How long is the flight from Australia to New Zealand? I think New Zealand, it still might be like hours long flight. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Is New Zealand the furthest place from New York or Australia?
What's the furthest? South, yeah.
Oh, that's not bad. Flights to New Zealand from Australia.
How long, though?
Yeah, how long? Oh, from Tauranga. Oh, Christchurch, New Zealand's another big one.
Queenstown,
Wellington.
It says a day, 20 hours. Seems to be the travel time.
From New Zealand to Australia?
Oh, no, from New Zealand to Australia.
Do they have, what kind of culture do they have there outside of their own?
I don't know. I don't think they really have a culture. I think they're cultureless.
Like?
Oh, you put Austria.
Oh.
Auckland.
By the way, Vienna, Austria, another place on the list. You ever been to Vienna, Austria?
I have not.
I would love to. Here's my top three. Vienna, Austria, Germany specifically during Christmas, and New Zealand.
Why specifically during Christmas?
Because I feel like it's a Christmas vibes, Germany. I want to go to Germany during Christmas.
Based on?
Just, I think, I feel like Christmas was invented in Germany. I think Christmas trees come from Germany. I don't know. Christmas chocolates.
They go hard in the paint with Christmas?
I thought Santa was German. Is Santa not German?
I think Klaus, right?
Klaus.
Santa Claus.
Klaus. You ever been to Germany?
No.
We got to go to
Germany. It's one of the places over there I have not yet gone.
You want to do a show in Germany?
Could we sell ticks there?
Why the hell? Email the podcast, heybaypod@gmail.com, or DM us. If you're a fan in Germany, can we sell ticks in Germany?
I never get, like, come to Germany.
There's a lot of American bases on. Do you know still to this day, it's 2021, you know still to this day, the nation of Germany cannot have an army above like 50,000 people from World War II. They still to this day, and our bases, U.S. military bases, are still in Germany to this day as part of the treaties after World War II that still have to abide by those rules. How crazy is that?
I did not know that.
Well,
you know what happened.
Germany does not have an army.
Germany done fucked up, though.
Germany done fucked up.
Yeah.
What Germany did in the 40s was they came out the pocket. They came out their face a little bit.
Right.
And so once Germany was out the pocket, we have to say, you know what now?
Yeah.
Unfortunately for you, hon, you can't anymore.
Nah.
Now you came out the pocket.
You're going to be reduced to sausage and chocolate now.
That's what it is, babes.
Is it chocolate over there?
They got big chocolate over there.
Big chocolate, right?
Yeah, dude, when I went to Oktoberfest in Munich, Germany, which was unbelievable, so much fun.
That's a shit show though, right?
Oh, God.
But in the best way?
Well, but when I went.
I always think of European vacation when I think of that.
But we explored. We went out. We went to Austria. We saw where Mozart was from, which was beautiful. Salzburg, Austria. If you ever get a chance to go to Salzburg, Austria, go. It was the most beautiful place anywhere. Like coffee shops were like inside castles with like amazing, unbelievable Austrian coffee and chocolates.
Let me ask you this.
Yes.
What do you eat in breakfast, lunch, and dinner over there? Is it like just brat?
Burger King.
Brat everything? You are.
I ate a little bit.
Because you need to have the consistency. Yeah.
I will say this, and this is no...
Wait. What's up, everybody? Want to talk to you about Ritual, my multivitamin of choice. I've been using it for months now. I've been a multivitamin guy forever, and I'm really liking Ritual for a lot of reasons that they separate themselves from a lot of other vitamins. What they say is that we deserve to know what we're putting in our bodies and why, especially when it comes to something that we take every day. I agree with that. Ritual has clean, vegan-friendly multivitamins. They're formulated with high-quality ingredients in different bioavailable forms that your body can actually use. You won't find sugars, GMOs, major allergens, synthetic fillers, or artificial colorants, which are in a lot of other vitamins. Plus, the fresh taste and delayed-release capsules design make taking your vitamins easy. Ritual is made traceable. That's the one thing that really like got my interest when I first saw it. You'll always know what nutrients you're taking and where they come from because they have their one-of-a-kind visible supply chain, which I think is kind of cool, especially now when we don't know what the hell we're putting in our bodies. A lot of times I'll order off of like online and you get like janky, like you think you're ordering one thing and it comes and you're like, this looks like it, but it's not. And I don't know what I'm putting, you know? So
yeah,
this is like, that's why I
really, the rocket fuel, like in Hey Babe,
we found out that there's rocket fuel in breast milk because it's seeping
into our food.
Yeah. Into our foods. Okay. Ritual makes healthy habits easy. Your multivitamins are delivered to your door every month with free shipping always. So that's it. You don't have to go out for them. You can start, snooze, or cancel your subscription anytime. That's another thing I love. It's not going to just come every month. If you don't want it, you could pause it or cancel it anytime. It's real easy. If you don't love Ritual, your first month, they'll refund you your order. There's nothing to lose with this multivitamin. Get key nutrients without the BS. Ritual is offering our listeners 10% off during your first 3 months. Visit ritual.com/heybabe to start your ritual today. Hey, everybody, want to talk to you about Upstart. Upstart are personal loans that you can get online. Look, if you're carrying credit card balance every month and you feel like you're in a never-ending cycle of debt, which I think most of us are, and there might be no end in sight, Upstart can help you make that final payment and finally get ahead. If you dread looking at your credit card statements, you're not alone. I was once $36,000 in debt coming just a little out of college because I had my student loans and stuff like that. I was working off the books. And it was the worst feeling I ever had. It took me 3 years, but I got out of it. But I know that feeling. Most people know that feeling. The weight of debt can be crippling. But Upstart can help you on your path to financial freedom. Upstart is the fast and easy way to pay off your debt with a personal loan all online. Whether it's paying off your credit cards, consolidating your high interest debt, or funding personal expenses, over a million people have started Upstart. Fixed monthly payment with a clear payoff date. Rather than looking at a credit score alone, Upstart considers other factors like your income, your current employment, and your credit history to find you a smarter rate for your loan. You can check your rate without impacting your credit score in minutes. That's something I'm always afraid of too, that every time I do an inquiry into my credit, I've always heard that wasn't good. They have loans from $1,000 to $50,000, and you can receive funds as fast as a business day after you accepting your loan. Find out how Upstart can lower your monthly payments today when you go to upstart.com/heybabe. That's upstart.com/heybabe. Don't forget to use our URL to let them know the babe sent you. Loan amounts will be determined based on your credit, income, and certain other information provided in your loan application. upstart.com/heybabe. You didn't try the cuisine?
I did. What I'm about to say, this is no disrespect to the people of Deutschland. No disrespect to them at all. But
if you're listening, we know that you are.
We know that you are. Zagat or Zagat?
Oh.
Zagat?
Zagat.
Zagat?
Yeah.
Zagat.
You know why I know that, right? I told you that. One time I said Zagat, and the person I used to work with like 20 years ago in an office in the city, she was like, it's Zagat. I was like, fuck, I'm going to hate you forever right now.
I hate you forever. So Zagat.
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 Is what she said.
Zagat.
Yeah.
So Zagat, one of the highest rated Zagat rated restaurants in Munich, Germany, I swear to Christchurch, New Zealand, gave their best dish was a piece of a pretzel and a hot dog not in the bun.
No.
With a side of mustard and a stein of beer. I swear
you
to God.
Can't do it.
I said, what is this?
That's wild.
That was their main German dish. It was a hot dog, not in the bun, and half a pretzel with mustard.
Pimp, what is the life expectancy of a German? In Germany.
In Germany.
Because you can't just throw down.
Can't live like that.
Wurst and pretzels.
Shout out Glockenspiels, which are clocks in Germany. Shout out to Glockenspiel.
You think they walk around in wooden clogs like that for real? You can't.
I don't think they do it every day.
You'll be dead.
Yeah, you can't do that every day. Yeah. I mean, whoever developed the wooden shoe.
I don't know.
It was a little disrespectful. I mean,
my mom used to be like, you look at those shoes, they look like clogs for when we were little, I went to Catholic school, and you used to have like special uniform shoes. You had to go to like Stride Right or Tom McCann and get these. And the heels were like that. And she goes, you used to have on clogs. And then she said this word that I haven't thought of until you just said that. I'm not 30 something years. And I don't know what's real word or she said it, but she goes, you got on cadiddle hoppers. Have you ever heard of that?
I've never heard of it, but that is the name of the episode is cadiddle hoppers.
Cadiddle hoppers.
Yeah.
To this day, I don't know if she made that up, but that's a real thing.
I thought that was like a living dictator.
You got your cadiddle hoppers on. Yeah. I was like,
I actually had to wear wooden shoes as a kid because I'm flat footed.
Wait, what?
They make us flat feet people wear wooden shoes.
I'm severely flat footed. I thought that would hurt. That would kill us.
How did a wooden shoe help?
There's just all these photos of me with stupid shoes on at Disney World.
Wait a minute. What do you mean a wooden shoe?
It was like a wooden corrective shoe.
You walked around Disney World. I mean, it's a walking affair, Disney World.
Yeah,
you tapped around in wooden clogs as a child.
In wooden shoes. Oh my God! Like a small Austrian woman.
My mom always tells me that story. She was mortified because I had wooden shoes on. I was cute, and when the characters would come up, I'd scream at them.
No,
yeah, I don't know.
It's
why.
Like you were from the place. You were from Deutschland in Epcot. Dude. 80.94 years? That's more than us.
No. Well, it says, but on the right, though, it says France is 76. Wait.
Oh, it's by year or no? Are you going by year? Oh, yeah, he's going by year.
Wow, so by year. So right now, wow.
81.
So in 2019, the gap has widened. The United States life expectancy is going down. Germany and France is going up. Wait, that has to be food related. Or maybe it's because we drink, maybe because we have rocket fuel in our milk. That's a true stat. That's a fact. There's rocket fuel in dairy. What? Google rocket fuel dairy. Are your balls in a safe space?
They're there. They're in place.
Okay. Well,
wait.
Blown off.
Where
right?
do you read this stuff? What papers? What periodicals are you reading?
What? Scientists on Tuesday just reported that percolate,
a
toxic component of rocket fuel, was contaminating virtually all samples of women's breast milk, and its levels were found to be on average 5 times greater than in cow's milk. So our ladies out there, we're shooting out rocket fuel because this is the United States.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, we got a land full of rocket fuel titties.
That's what, how do you think you're going to beat any country listening right now? Germany, how can you beat us in a war when our women are literally spitting rocket fuel out their titties?
Yeah. We'll never run out of fuel.
Well, dude, it's like, hey, I got to go to the pump. Pull out a titty, Sally.
Yeah, I actually drank breast milk.
Wow.
Well, you drank market.
They made me drink it. It did not taste good. But
did you go into outer space?
No. I have a question. How?
I don't know.
Why do women have rocket fuel?
Because I think there's rocket fuel, small things of rocket fuel in all. Is there rocket fuel in milk? Yes.
Oh, my God.
There's rocket fuel in milk.
And store-bought milk?
And store-bought milk. Rocket fuel, baby. Rocket man.
It can impede adult metabolism. And cause retardation in fetuses.
So let me ask you a question. Oh, when my 4-month-old runs out of formula, can I just give her a little, can I just take her to the pumps?
Just get to the fuel.
Can I just go to Sunoco?
Yeah. Fill her up.
God. Fill her up. Oh, but that's gas.
That's weird that it says it could cause that in children, and yet you always hear breast milk is the most healthy thing for the baby's immunity.
I mean, we've spoken, though, about this already. That I mean, all our kids, there's plastic now in every kid. All our kids are turning into plastic.
Wow.
And I guess they're plastic-filled rocket fuel. You know, little babies. I wonder if is there rocket fuel in everybody's breasty milk?
It just seems like the plants are leaking rocket fuel into the food and water supplies around the country, it says.
Oh my God. That's how? I thought like we maybe produced it also in our bodies.
What, like the Elton John song?
It's amazing.
Rocket fuel filling up the titties all night long.
Oh, do you have to open the door?
Want
to
pause it?
Yeah.
I don't know who that could be, though.
DeRosa.
Oh, it's DeRosa. Oh, it's open. Like, that's wild that it's because the plants are leaking it into the earth.
Yeah.
And food and water supplies.
Yeah.
So we're just consuming it.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
We just consume it all, and then the babies eat plastic, and it's just what it is. But here's the thing, though. Here's what I've learned at BetterHelp, if they're still a sponsor. If not, then I've learned it somewhere else.
Yeah.
That you have to just let go. Like, even like when you're like, you know, a vegan or trying to eat healthy, there's crap like in every.
You can never, yeah.
So just literally just like let it go. And it's like, when you're going to die, you're going to die. You're probably going to die at about 78 years old. That's the, oh man, the average life expectancy of an American is 78.
78.9 or something like that. I have a question. How is it possible that the average life expectancy is more in Germany than it is here with their diet?
Well, because I don't think because
they eat all natural though.
They eat all natural.
Pretzels aren't all natural.
They're not, but you know what it is? They eat there's just
extremely. They'll eat one sausage all day.
Like, we're in a 2,000 calorie diet. That's what it says, like American USDA 2,000 calorie diet. I think the Europe's like 1,500. They're like, if you go on 2,000, like, oh God, you piece of pig shit.
Yeah, but they eat one sausage. That's fucking 2,000 calories.
Yeah, but I don't think that it's. I think that they're like the factories. I don't know.
There's less chemicals leaked in their food. There's no rocket fuel in them.
Maybe the Germans march more.
Maybe they do.
That's what it is. They get their exercise out. Yeah.
They get more calisthenics.
Who's this?
I did find something I thought was terrifying, and I feel like Sal would love it.
Oh, get right now, this is gonna scare Sal.
Oh yeah.
This is gonna really terrify Sal right now. Get ready for this.
So this is the future of deepfakes, which is the next wave of media coming.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
They're saying that
they're gonna have to put money into figuring out the technology to show that it's fake, because it's going to be so real that if we can't disprove it, it's going to cause a lot of problems.
Shout out deepfakes. Deepfake porn is, I mean, amazing.
Oh my God.
Whoever your favorite star is that obviously would never do porn, they get deepfaked. It's, you know.
All right. Clear my schedule. Clear my schedule. Don't call me the next 3 days.
Yeah.
I'll come out on the other side. Let you know how it was.
I'll tell you some good deepfakes.
I'll come out on the other side.
My favorite, just before we go, favorite deepfake Hillary Clinton. Go ahead.
Oh, no.
No, I'm kidding.
Hey, everybody. Let's chat about Mint Mobile. After years of fine print contracts and getting ripped off by a big wireless providers, you know who you are. If we learned anything, it's that there's always a catch. So when we first got Mint Mobile on the pod as a sponsor, we learned they offer premium wireless service starting at $15 a month. Everyone's thinking the same thing. No way. What's the catch? It's not $15. But after we found out about this product and you actually started using it,
I love it.
It is $15. It starts at $15 a month.
No, for real.
And you told me that you see no difference in service. It's
zero.
Than when you used.
Yep.
We won't mention.
Yeah,
the
wireless.
The provider that should not be mentioned. you love it. Mint Mobile's secret sauce is that they're the first company to sell wireless service online only. And by cutting out the retail stores, there's no crazy overhead costs that get passed down to you. There's no mystery fees. Instead, Mint just passes on sweet savings directly to you. Pimpy loves it. You'll love it. I haven't had a chance to switch yet, but I am seriously considering now that I spoke to you. I want to see what it's all about. For people looking for extra savings, Mint Mobile offers premium wireless for $15 a month. Just $15. All the plans come with unlimited talk and text, high-speed data delivered over the nation's largest 5G network. Use your own phone with any Mint Mobile plan and keep your same phone number with all your existing contacts. They couldn't make it easier. You just switch over, you pay $15 a month, and everything else stays exactly the same. And if you're not 100% satisfied, Mint Mobile has you covered with a 7-day money-back guarantee. Switch to Mint Mobile and get premium wireless service starting at just $15 a month. To get your new wireless plan for just $15 a month and get the plan shipped to your door for free, go to mintmobile.com/heybabe. That's mintmobile.com/heybabe. Cut your wireless bill to $15 a month at mintmobile.com/heybabe. Have you guys heard of Liquid IV yet? Because a few weeks ago, before they were a sponsor of the podcast, a friend of mine, when I had a rough day the next day, he goes, I'm coming over tonight. He was coming over for dinner. He goes, I'll bring you Liquid IV. I didn't know what it was. A couple days later, we got sponsored by the podcast. I got a box of Liquid IV downstairs. We have 6 packages if you want.
Nice. Oh, yeah.
I started using it immediately. So, because I've been trying to do this thing now that I've been promising myself that I go through. Where's my water? I'm going through my 40-ounce water. I'm trying to drink 3 a day. What?
It's inside of the.
Oh, he's inside Gonzo to make Gonzo stand up. All right, everybody.
Oh, man. That was like a video I saw once. All right. No, just about hydration. I've been trying to drink three of these a day, and I'm all about the hydration now because it suppresses my appetite. It makes my skin glow like a mofo. Anyway, everybody knows the importance of hydration. So I start now not only doing that, but I take a liquid IV every day because it's just full season's in full swing, first of all. Proper hydration and vitamins support my immune system. We know that. One stick of liquid IV in a 16-ounce water hydrates faster and more efficiently than water alone. And they got cool flavors. They have watermelon, strawberry, lemon, lime. I take it when I get up because I try to drink through the night, but usually when I get up after a long night, like, I want to start with a lot.
You need it sometimes.
Yeah, I do. So as soon as I get up, I take mine. It's just easy. It's really easy. It's just I have it by the bedside with a 16-ounce water. I pour it in and I gulp it. It's the first thing I do when I get up.
I usually have one at the gym. And it tastes like a weird, like fruity water. It's
like
nice.
Yeah, it tastes like almost like a punch or a fruit juice. Yeah. Yeah, like I said, they have lemon lime, strawberry, watermelon, passion fruit. Guava is my favorite. I haven't tried pina colada, but they have tangerine, immune support in tangerine. So they contain five essential vitamins, more vitamin C than an orange, as much potassium as a banana. They are not like the sugary sports drinks, though. They have no artificial flavors or preservatives and less sugar than an apple. So they taste great, but they are not like those watery, sugary drinks. Non-GMO, vegans, they're for you too. Gluten people, free of gluten, dairy, and soy. Okay. The company's donating 4 million servings in response to COVID-19. Products are being donated to hospitals, first responders, food banks, veterans, and active military. This stuff is spreading like wildfire. I hear everybody talking about it now. I'm so glad they came on as a sponsor. Grab your favorite liquid IV flavors nationwide at Walmart, or you can get 25% off when you go to liquidiv.com and use code HEYBABE at checkout. That's 25% off anything you order from them. And you get better hydration today using promo code HEYBABE at liquidiv.com.
Imagine.
Well, the crazy,
I'm sure there is.
Oh, yeah, there has to be.
The crazy part is the future of it could be that you don't need camera people or a movie. You just need the script. And
how do you feel about that, homeless pimp?
I'll be long dead by the time good. I figure it out.
Oh, then I will be too.
Yeah. But anyway. Yeah,
pimp's going to outlive everybody. Yeah. All he does is eat salads and drink beers. Yeah. People are yelling salad and beer at him when we went to Nashville.
They really?
Like, salad and beer. We got to make merch, salad, and beer.
So you're yin yang.
Yeah. I mean, he's lost the 30, 40. Easy. Go ahead. This guy sounds like he has a British accent. Oh, he doesn't.
This is how I looked 30 years
ago. This is already funny.
But I could tell he looks like a computer there.
Oh, it morphed in that second?
Yeah.
What are you talking about? You didn't see it morph?
I didn't see it.
Watch this again. You didn't see it morph? Look at this. Watch when he turns to the camera. His face morphed. Look at this. Watch. Watch him morph.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I saw it
that
time.
You missed that the first time?
Yeah. It was subtle. It looks so real. That looks like a regular... I don't think that looks fake. He even had the sweat on his nose.
Uh-oh, German.
It's called deep fake.
Yeah, you do want to fool people because you're a deep fuck. Now, whose face is this?
So, this is them. This company they run can... Pretty much if you film a commercial spot, can customize it for every country, and you don't have to film anything extra. So this is an example of that.
Wow.
Well, it's no one's going to have jobs.
That's going to take work away, yeah. Oh,
come on, dude. Just eat me.
Why did Snoop come into this?
Damn.
Wow.
And they can even replicate your voice.
Did Snoop Dogg get paid?
I'm sure he had to sign some deal.
I'll tell you who.
Snoop Dogg get paid.
Snoop Dogg get paid. You know who they might have deepfaked? Tom Brady, because how is he?
How is he
doing this at 43 years old?
I don't think he did it. I think it was a deepfake.
Yeah, it could be someone else. You know, it could be like a Baker Mayfield with a Tom Brady face, maybe.
I think it was. And shout out, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Patrick Mahomes, who might have been the real winner of the Super Bowl.
Right.
Maybe Patrick Mahomes deepfaked Tom Brady, and it was Patrick Mahomes being Tom Brady, and really Patrick Mahomes won, but he's got to take that secret to the grave.
Either way, shout out both teams. They got good organizations, and I'm really excited that they played that well, and I look forward to the future football.
I look forward to the future at all. And shout out Florida. Shout out Kansas City, which is in Missouri, which will be there December 29th.
Absolutely.
At the factory. And a lot of host of other dates.
Now, the most interesting thing in this was...
Are they walking around London? I love London!
Is that they're advising future movie stars to go get their face AI recognized so that they
now
can release the rights to their image when they're old and haggard.
Wow.
So did Robert De Niro deepfake his face in The Irishman, right?
I think it was a little weird, though. Was it weird, right?
It didn't play.
It wasn't as good as this guy.
The tech wasn't there yet. It felt weird looking at it.
Now you get deep. When I see London, I get happy, by the way. Does London make you happy?
I love London.
I
love it.
Could you live in London?
I believe that I could.
I could live, I'm telling you. I don't want to leave New York.
Every time I go, I love it.
If I was going to live anywhere outside New York, I would live in bloody London.
Yeah.
That's where I would live.
When my kids
When my kids turn 18, when the little one turns 18, if they don't want me in their life anymore, I will move to London.
London town.
I encourage my kids to go to London. Tom Cruise looks like a chipmunk.
Yeah, look at this. That's fake?
That's fake.
No, stop it.
Wow.
No. Wait a minute.
Wow.
Wait a second.
That's just a regular guy?
To do my own music.
This is not Tom. Oh my God.
A series of hyper-realistic deepfakes of the movie star that began appearing on the video sharing app.
There I could tell a little bit.
Hey, what's up, TikTok?
For days, people wondered if they were real. And if not,
the first one with the guitar is actually mortifying.
Wild.
It's just scary. Like, how do you even fight this?
I want a deepfake pimp's face. I want a deepfake pimp's face and laugh.
On both of us for a whole pod.
Oh, my God. There's no way you could do that, right?
No.
I like when Pimp admits he can't do something.
Yeah.
You can't outsmart the Belgian Elon Musk.
Not today.
Oh, my God. So, but you think deepfake, you think stuff, Pimp, let me ask you, you know technology and where it goes. This is going to be available to my six-year-old in a year.
No, this is a problem for your six-year-old when she's 20.
Because she'll be like... Because
people will be like, oh, I did a deepfake of my classmate doing this or that.
Then it's like, did you really
and
do
then
it?
If the school's going to be like, did you say that?
Do you think
did
somebody's going to get convicted of a crime that was a victim of a deepfake? Is that going to happen?
Oh, wow.
There's definitely going to be a deepfake terrorist.
Yeah, right? 100%. 100%. Yeah, because if I'm deepfaking on the terrorist camera, you'll never know who the real person was. I deepfaked it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if they want to get real cute, they could just deepfake. They could be like, turn on the camera and it's like Tom Cruise is the terrorist. You know what I mean?
Oh, it'd be so funny.
That's like just throwing it in our face. Like, take on Beloved. Like, it's Tom Hanks and he's like, you have 1 hour or his head comes off. Love Hanks.
That'd be so great.
Love Hanks.
Yeah, it'd be funny if, like, you know, some terrorists, like, you know, deep fake like some video and they deep fake like they made them face Greta von Thunberg. You know, like some like activist.
It's like the Dalai Lama.
Yeah. Jesus. Bubs, what do you want? So, dude, thank God you ate before, because I'm just gonna say this, and Pimp, you know, we're all on the same team here. But the beginning of the podcast, I could tell something was off.
I didn't feel myself.
You didn't feel yourself.
Yeah, I hadn't eaten today.
Yeah, you hadn't eaten, because I was just like, we were a little like, oh man, what's happened? So I just want to shout out, what's the restaurant again?
Pastavino
again. Thank God you kind of saved the episode. You saved Sal, because I mean, he was really being like very, very moody.
Yeah.
So
you know, yeah, it was just, you were like blue, you know?
Yeah, I didn't feel myself at all.
But it's good. But now you feeling yourself?
I feel myself.
I'm feeling myself.
This has been Hey Babe. Burr.
This has been, who's Derek?
Oh, it was just the name of a comedy troupe.
That no, it's not
like 20 years ago that were coming up when I was coming up. Actually, who was in it when I was? It was Donald Glover, actually. That was where he started.
Donald.
And DC Pearson, and then Dominic. And I don't want to get his name, last name wrong. I think it's Dirks or
Dierks. Well, I'm from Deutschland. It's Dierks.
Oh, Dierks.
Dominic Dierks.
Yeah. Funny guys. Yeah. And then this guy, Dan Ekman, was the filmmaker. I don't know.
Just a Derek comedy
shout
fan.
Out to them.
Shout out Derek. Did you ever see that show Derek on Netflix?
Oh, it's good.
Great show with Ricky Gervais. Oh my God.
Yeah.
One of the best shows of all time.
I haven't seen it, though.
You think Derek stinks?
That's DeRosa. Oh, God.
Joe DeRosa yelling from down below. Joe DeRosa, me and Sal's feature, yelling from down below.
That's...
Sorry.
DeRosa yelling from the pits of hell.
Yeah, from the pits of hell, but it does smell good down there. What did you bring, sandwiches? It smells great.
Dude, do you know that he? Do you realize he's only one time in like a year brought sandwiches?
Yeah. What the fuck, dude? Oh, dude, we were supposed to get coffee yesterday. I forgot.
Yeah, I know. You're a fucking dumb
flake
who likes Derek.
I love Derek.
Such a good show.
All right. Well, this has been Hey Babe, and those bleeps you heard were from the pig. Las Vegas pre-sale happening right now, March 25th at the Wynn. I'm coming. I'm bringing TT Jerry. An hour of stand-up at the Wynn Hotel, March 25th. Pre-sale happening right now. Use the code CHAOS at ChrisDComedy.com. Go get the tickets. We're going to have a great time over there at the Wynn. Love Las Vegas. The Beacon Theater. We have released some tickets. February 5th, New York City. Go to ChrisDComedy.com for all the tickets. We got a whole theater tour coming out. Thank you guys so much for the support. Go get the tickets. And at the end of December, with Sally Babe, my baby, we're co-headlining. We got Texas. We got Ohio. We got Missouri. Go get the tickets. ChrisDComedy.com. Thanks, baby.
All right, I finally got some dates for you guys. I will be at the Dania Improv in Fort Lauderdale on November 12th, 13th, and 14th. I will be at the West Palm Beach Improv December 4th and 5th. I will be in Boston in the Medford area at the Chevalier Theater on December 10th. And how about this? First time playing Atlantic City solo. I'm at the Borgata Saturday, December 11th. Come on down for that. All tickets at SalVulcanoComedy.com right now, and more dates to be announced soon. I have not been out. I'm finally coming out after COVID. You better be there.
Don't be a fake. Don't be a flake. Don't run away from your feelings, babe. Don't be a fake.